Class we have seen about the structure of neuron and types of neuron. Today we are going to see about the nervous system regarding the types of nervous system. Before we going to see that what is called a neurotransmitter, which is actually the chemical substances which is filled in the neurons. Understand? So in the chemical substance nothing but the acetylcholine, which actually release the transfer the impulses from the one axon of the neuron to another terminal end of the neuron, which is by means of the neurotransmitter, which is the chemical substance we are called acetylcholine. Next one is the human nervous system. Human nervous system is nothing but a well-developed nervous system, because we have only to think and take action. So that is why human are the advanced animal, to think and have to actions depending upon the sensations. Understand? So the human nervous system is divided into central nervous system, peripheral nervous system and autonomic nervous system. The central nervous system consists of brain and spinal cord. The peripheral nervous system consists of nerves which connect to brain and spinal cord and to all parts of the body. Autonomic nervous system comprises sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves. So the human nervous system having three types of nervous system. Before we going to see about the nervous system, the brain and the spinal cord are well developed in human. It give information, processor and control the whole body. Understand? The central nervous system, the brain and the spinal cord is protected by the bony skull and vertebral column respectively. Understand? So the brain is also called as the controlling center of the body. The central nervous system having two types of matter, that is white matter and gray matter, which depending upon the presence or absence of the myelin sheath on the neuron. Understand? The brain is covered by brain as well as the spinal cord, always covered by three meninges, that is dura mater, arachnoid membrane and pia mater. The dura mater is the outermost layer, which is the fibrous thick one. Arachnoid membrane is the middle, which is the vascularized one. Vascularization means highly vascularized, which supplies the blood to the brain. And the innermost layer, just outer the brain, that is called as the pia mater, inner to the arachnoid membrane and dura mater. Understand? So this is the inner layer, this is the middle layer, this is the outermost layer. So these three constitute to protect the brain from mechanical injury. Understand? The brain is divided into three regions: forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. Forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. The forebrain, which consists of the cerebrum, thalamus and hypothalamus. So forebrain, cerebrum, thalamus and hypothalamus. The cerebrum is the largest part of the brain, which occupies two-third of the brain, largest portion. The right and left halves is divided by means of the median cleft. Understand? So the outermost region is the cerebral cortex and the inner region is cerebral medulla. Understand? The two median cleft connected by a highly nervous tissue, that is called as corpus callosum. Understand? The cerebral cortex, the outer portion is gray in matter and the inner portion is white in matter. We already know, depending upon the presence or absence of myelin sheath, we are called gray matter and white matter. And the outer portion of the forebrain, that is the cerebrum, is having folded elevation, which is numerous in number, which is known as gyri and sulci, which increases the external surface of the cerebrum. Understand? Then the each hemisphere, two cerebral hemisphere, which consist of frontal lobe, parietal lobe and temporal lobe and occipital lobe. There are four lobes are present in each hemispheres. That is two hemispheres having these four lobes. The functions of the cerebrum is to nothing but thinking, intelligence, reasoning, willpower, memory, imagination, etc., which is a important portion of the brain. Then the forebrain. The thalamus is present in the cerebral medulla. It is the major conducting center for sense and motor signaling. Sensor and motor signaling. The thalamus conduct the cerebral medulla. It actually acts as a relay center. Then hypothalamus lies at the base of the thalamus. The hypothalamus lies at the base of the thalamus. It actually regulates the temperature. That is why we are called as thermoregulatory center. And it also controls the involuntary functions like hunger, thirst, sleep, sweat, anger, fear, sexual desire. Understand? So these are the involuntary functions. நம்மளை அறியாமல் நடக்கிற ஃபங்க்ஷன்ஸை கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ணுறது தான் ஹைப்போ தலாமஸ். அண்ட் இட் ஆல்சோ கண்ட்ரோல்ஸ் த செக்ரீஷன் ஆஃப் ஹார்மோன்ஸ் ஆஃப் த ஆன்டீரியர் பிட்யூட்ரி. வெரி இம்பார்ட்டண்ட் ஃபங்க்ஷன். த ஹைப்போ தலாமஸ் இஸ் ஆக்சுவல் லிங்க் பிட்வீன் த நர்வஸ் சிஸ்டம் அண்ட் எண்டோக்ரைன் சிஸ்டம். தென் த ஃபோர் பிரெயின் இஸ் ஃபாலோட் பை த மிட் பிரெயின். The midbrain is located between the thalamus and the hindbrain. The dorsal portion consists of four rounded bodies. We are called as corpora quadrigemina. Understand? The midbrain actually controls the visual and auditory reflexes because the optic lobe and auditory lobes are present in the midbrain. Then hindbrain. The hindbrain formed of three parts, that is nothing but cerebellum, pons and medulla oblongata. The cerebellum is the second largest part regarding the, when compared to the cerebrum, it is the second largest part. It also two large sized hemispheres and the middle portion is we are called a vermis. Understand? The cerebellum coordinates the voluntary movements like walking, running, jumping, like that, coordinating the voluntary movements and maintains the body balance. That is actually the posture of the body is maintained by the cerebellum. Then pons. The pons connects the two lobes of the cerebellum. It actually relays the signals between the cerebrum, cerebellum, spinal cord. Understand? It controls the sleep cycle and respiration. நம்ம தூங்குறதை ஆக்சுவலாக கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ணுறது வந்து இந்த பான்ஸ். சிக்ஸ் ஹவர்ஸ் செவன் ஹவர்ஸ் தூங்குறோம் இல்லையா, அதை வந்து மெயின்டைன் பண்ணுறது பான்ஸ். தென் ஃபைனலி மெடுலா ஆப்ளங்கேட்டா. இட் இஸ் அ போஸ்டீரியர் பார்ட் ஆஃப் த பிரைன். அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்? விச் கனெக்ட்ஸ் த ஸ்பைனல் கார்டு அண்ட் த பிரைன். கனெக்ஷன் பிட்வீன் த ஸ்பைனல் கார்டு அண்ட் பிரைன் இஸ் நத்திங் பட் த மெடுலா ஆப்ளங்கேட்டா. இட் ஹேஸ் three centers, that is cardiac center, respiratory center and vasomotor centers. So cardiac means, you know, it controls the heartbeat, especially heartbeat. So we are called as cardiac center. Respiration, you know, the breathing is also controlled by the medulla oblongata and vasomotor. Vasomotor means vascular tissues, that is the blood vessel, nothing but the blood vessels. So it controls the heartbeat, respiration, contraction of blood vessels. That is the vasomotor activity, contraction of blood vessels and also regulating the vomiting and salivation. நம்ம வாமிட் பண்ணுறது, சலைவரி செக்ரீஷன் பண்ணுறது தான் ஆக்சுவலாக கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ணுறது மெடுல்லா அப்படிங்கிட்டா. ஓகே, தேங்க்யூ ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், யூ வில் சி லேட்டர்.